My name is Dagmar Painter. I'm the curator of Gallery Al-Quds here at the Jerusalem Fund, and I'm very happy to welcome you all to our space. And I'm most happy and proud to be able to exhibit the work of Samar Hussaini, who's going to speak to you for a little bit and tell you a little bit about her process and the meaning behind some of the beautiful work that we've been looking at this evening. And there will be time for questions if you have any. And afterwards, please go back out into the gallery and continue to enjoy yourself. No further ado, here's Samar.
Ahlan wa sahlan, welcome. And thank you for joining me. First off, I want to thank the Jerusalem Fund, Gallery Al-Quds, and the curator, Ms. Painter, for inviting me and doing such a wonderful job with the curation. It's really quite beautiful, and I really appreciate it. And most of all, I want to thank my dear friends and family who came tonight and who support me and push me to create and follow my dream, which is really wonderful. My name is Samar Hussaini, and I am a Palestinian American. I was born in Northampton, Massachusetts, and both my parents, Hatem and Lema Hussaini, are Palestinian and were born in Jerusalem. My father came to the States to get his PhD from the University of Massachusetts and was soon offered a teaching position at Smith College. After I was born, we moved to DC, where my father worked for the Arab League and later worked as a political activist for the Palestinian cause. He opened the first Palestinian Information Office in Washington, and as a result of his political activity, he was barred from returning to his homeland. My mother, along with other Arab and American women, established the Union of Arab Women volunteering to promote dialogue, cultural exchange, and fundraising. That was the 70s. Living outside of DC, I was surrounded by culture, diversity, good food, and of course the news that was on 24/7 in my house. In 1975, when I was 5 years old, my mother tells me how I said to her, "Palestinians are bad." She asked, "Who told you that?" And I replied, "Television." She says it broke her heart. My father shortly after wrote an op-ed in the New York Times titled "Yearning for Palestine." He wrote about seeing himself distorted in the media so many times. He wrote about me and what happened with my mother, and he explained that they told me, "No, beautiful one, we Palestinians are good. We want peace, brotherhood, happiness. We have to repeat to Americans every day, we want peace in Palestine." They never stopped reminding me how proud I should always be for being Palestinian and what a positive thing it was. I am now a mother of two children, ages 6 and 8, and I worry that my children will say the same thing that I said to my parents in 1975. I continue to tell my children what my parents told me. Palestinians are good. We want peace, brotherhood, happiness, and I paint to tell the story of Palestinian culture and the Palestinian people in a positive light. I'm looking to transform that narrative portrayed during this turbulent time. I want to reveal the Palestinian people in a humanizing way and depict the layers of rich culture that create our strong identity. Our culture and people are filled with rich history. Every year as a child, I would visit my family in Jerusalem with wide eyes, amazed at the beauty of the countryside, the delicious food, the generous, friendly family and people. Those are the narratives I want to reveal, telling the story of Palestinian people in a positive light, empowering my children and generations to come to grow up feeling proud. I use traditional embroidered Palestinian cross stitch and the hand-stitched tob, a dress that represents regional identity unique to each town and village. The keffiyeh, which is a traditional headscarf, now has come to be known as an icon of resistance, and the writings of my father from over 25 years ago, or 40, that speaks to the continuing plight of the Palestinian people. In 1992, my father was finally granted return to his homeland and proudly accepted the position of president of the Jerusalem University. Soon after, he passed away in December 1994. He always spoke about creating empathy and humanizing Palestinians in hopes that people would hear him and grow from what that they heard. I paint so that others may see a different story. To continue his hopes and dreams, in his words, we want peace and brotherhood in Palestine. So my child, all children, will play in peace under the ancient olive trees and sing and learn the Arab and Jewish heritage and culture. I am Samar Hussaini. I am Palestinian American. My art is a record of my Palestinian identity. You and every viewer are part of my achievement. Shukran, thank you.